life here in Corsica is just slow and beautiful, you know. We take our time to do things, we enjoy everything. We don't have the hustle bustle of bigger cities, and I think that's what really attracts everybody to the area is the way that we live is just, I don't want to be cliche, but quaint.
Corsica is a very ag community, about 600 people. We've been a great small town for over 100 years, established in 1905 because of the railroad, and we've been flourishing ever since. Corsica grew in segments. We had no city architect to come in and say, this is where you need to go for future expansion. Our expansion happened and then our infrastructure happened. And so then everything got hodgepodge together. We don't know where everything should be. Then we end up where we are with poor records and poor infrastructure of where things are at.
I think that house got moved so that we don't know really have a starting point anymore to where we can go.
The Rural Community Development Program is a federal funded program that works with regional and tribal organizations to manage safe drinking water systems in rural communities.
Yeah, without going to measure and finding out exactly where we're at.
A thing with the small communities versus the large communities is that the small communities have pieced together their infrastructure, and so they've always relied on, well, Bob put this in 50 years ago. Well, unfortunately, Bob has now passed away, and now we don't know where the valves is. We don't know where that water line is.
This is where we had the burst about a year ago, coming up on a year.
Burst had to be fixed or repaired essentially live, which means water continued to flow. We eventually had to shut the whole town down instead of isolating the event.
Corsica went through a great fiber optic upgrade, and through having poor records of where our water lines were, they happened to bore right through a pipe. I kind of came up to the point of where we needed to update our infrastructure and put it into the 21st century.
We got this whole row of water lines that we have no clue what they really are.
Well, I just happened to be in the office one day and been looking at trying to get infrastructure upgrades, just finding out that it wasn't in our funding budgets to do anything at this moment. And then Jackie just happened to be in the office one day and we just got to talk and she looked at us and said, we can get funding for that for you.
The Rural Community Development Program works with water and wastewater infrastructure projects. Because it is so flexible, allows the communities to get what they need. GIS is a great tool that allows a community to not only be able to locate their infrastructure, it allows them to do asset management. So if you get it all on GIS, it's all digitized.
Midwest Assistance Program is a technical assistance providing organization. We serve 9 states in the Midwest. We focus on communities that are underserved, low income. We expect to impact over 1,000 communities within our region.
So with this technology, have you...
We're here to help you not only fix your problems, but create a sustained environment to where you can sustain them on your own.
Jackie, great to see you again.
Yeah, it's good to see you. Show me what you got going
on. Yeah, we got some great things going on in the new city. All that GIS infrastructure that we had done with RCD money, we got all up and going. As you can see, Jack, we got all our sewer and water lines here and everything.
Through Midwest Assistance Program, we were able to not only digitize where our locations are at, we actually get to have a whole data collection of what they are. So then we can start managing our funding of phasing out our old piece of equipment so that we can start updating all of our stuff to where it needs to be.
I think your general person off the street probably doesn't realize all a city goes through, and they really have taken all the right actions. They are embracing the technology, they are excited about it. It's something they're going to use, and it's something that's going to benefit their whole community.
Love your community, because we are a family in our community. I just got to treat it that way.